You see this beef going on with Ice Spice and her friend? Well, I wouldn't even call them friends because they only knew each other for 2 years. And I think that's the real start of the problem. They're like, I swear, yo. So, all right, we can talk about this. Ice Spice, she got into it with Cleo Trapper. These niggas is crazy, man.
Looks like an AI. Like, if imagine you came out from a coma and you saw this shit.
So I found out about Cleo Trapper just from like seeing her on the timeline. She was like, you know, just a funny personality on Twitter. And she started to grow a following, and then she transitioned that internet following into making music. And Ice Spice, she blew up by accident. Like, we gonna keep it all the way real. She blew up off of people making it a joke of, we both from the Bronx, so you know that we dirty. Their beef has started after Cleo Trapper, she posted, you know, just some videos on TikTok just talking about how she was treated after going on tour. Like, you know, she said Ice Spice invited her on tour with her. But throughout this tour, she was just being mistreated. She wasn't being taken care of in a way of, you know, Ice Spice would have security. The security wouldn't look out for her. People are carrying Ice Spice bags, and Cleo Trapper wondering why I gotta carry my own bag. And it's like, is that really too much to carry your own bag?
Yeah, she should talk to some like comedian openers. Yeah. Like, they gotta drive. They gotta not say something when the headliner assaults a woman. You don't even know how bad it could be out here. You gotta fucking think about how many niggas opened up for Bill Cosby. And shit, man. That was just like, I want to get on NBC one day. So
when did Ice Spice, when did she blow up? When did, like, because they say they've been friends for 2 years, and I think that's the issue. I wish we had a woman. We need a woman representative to talk about this. Y'all got to stop being cool with other people for the aesthetic.
Yeah, that's
the real problem. Corny. Like, we all, like, all right, when did Ice Spice, so...
A lot of my friends are ugly.
Okay, so she, so they started being cool after, like, around when she blew up. And the Cleopatra, she already had the following, too. Y'all not really friends. Y'all just happen to be two people that y'all both look good and y'all both successful in y'all own lanes.
Yeah, they
y'all
not got friends. Nothing in common.
Like, men, we don't care whether our friends attractive or not, or look good or not. We all cool, because the reason why this podcast works so well is because we're actually genuine friends. Like, we could actually hang and talk outside of this.
Yeah, like, if we couldn't talk, there really wouldn't be any reason for us to talk at all. Like, we have nothing in common.
Right.
No common ground.
With them, So Cleopatra, so she first started where she was saying how, like, you know, the security guards wouldn't carry her luggage to venues and things of that sort, right? And then...
Poor baby. Oh, I'm so sorry that you had to go through that.
Yeah. And then, you know, Ice Spice and her team, they went out to dinner, and then they told her, like, you know, basically she got to pay for her own food. And then...
Damn. that one's actually kind of... Yeah. Damn.
Yeah, and also... Ice Spice was staying, like, you know, getting certain accommodations. You know, she's the star of the tour where she's staying in, you know, 5-star hotels, and they're telling Cleo Trapper, like, she got to find her own accommodations. And that's, like, for me, that's kind of what, like, you know, with certain shows for us, right? I want to take openers to shows, or, like, you know, I want to take my friends to shows where I could treat them in the same way. You know, like, if you're performing with me, I want you to be treated like an extension of me. And just from, like, you know, the headliners I've worked with, like, you know, when I go on the road with, like, Shane, that's somebody I came up with. So it's like, he makes sure that, like, you know, his guys are taken care of and, like, in a good way. Or same thing, like, when I went on the road with Sam Morrell, I feel like that's how it should be. But with this, I kind of get both sides of it. It kind of get both sides. Ice Spice is probably looking at it like, yo, you was already popping before me. I thought you had it. Because one of the first times I've seen them together was at, like, a New York Knicks game. Ice Spice, she was like, you know, she responded to this. And also, it was a, It was some situation.
They did something in a Twitter space.
Yeah.
Nothing good comes of a
Twitter space. Yeah, she went right to Twitter space to defend herself, it says.
Yeah. Because like, Cleopatra, she also was telling a story about like how she, Ice Spice wouldn't even get her like a chicken salad.
All right, so the food thing, I definitely am like, you couldn't fucking feed your opener. But
I get that, but the carrying your bags, it's like, come on.
Carrying your bags in the hotel. The hotel thing where you be like, easily like, so like you booked rooms for everybody or should I get one? Like, right. That, like you don't go on tour thinking like this girl is going to fucking look out for you all the way.
But that's why I say like women got to stop being cool with each other just because they look good.
Yeah.
This is how like I've never seen men go on a trip or I've never seen men go on vacation and they come back not cool. But we see that shit happen with women all the time. It's like y'all go to Miami together. Y'all stay six deep in a room. And this is y'all first time struggling together because it ain't no man there providing for y'all. Whereas like men, we like being around each other just because we naturally cool. So it's like I have no problem struggling with my man. We came up broke together.
Yeah, I know what type of person you are. I know you're not the type of person to do that type of shit already. That's why we're going somewhere together. Because I already know, like, I got a sense of who you are.
Right. Whereas, like, y'all going there just to get y'all shit off of the gram.
Really? Like, they just go and twerk together and get followers? Like, that's basically it.
So that's what she basically was saying. So Ice Spice had said it to the point that Cleotrapa was just basically, I love it so much. Cleotrapa is the best. But she basically said that she can no longer use her audience anymore. And so it basically seemed at that point that's what the trade-off was.
You know, Ice Spice don't some got of my audience. Fans. She got Peeping Toms. That's what her stand base should be.
Yeah, bro. Peeping Toms. Creeps by things.
Dude. I know. Because even I seen it was like a lot of videos lately where, you know, we see Ice Spice on stage shaking her ass. And it's like, it's kind of sad. She just don't got that same love for it anymore. Whereas like the ass is shaking, but it's just the look in her eyes. I could tell she not. The ass shaking isn't coming from the heart anymore.
Nah, it's really not come from the heart anymore. It's kind of like when a lion becomes a man at the zoo and it's roaring, you know. But at a certain point, the lion goes, "If I don't roar, they're not gonna love me. I'm in captivity."
I'm gonna play some of this clip where Ice Spice was talking about this in the Twitter space.
All I could do is sigh about it, cause it's just like, what can you do, bro? It's like, damn. Crash outs and they going on rants, but fuck it though. At the end of the day, it's whatever, bro. Like,
wait, how old is she again? I don't wanna hear her talk.
No, but before I finish 22. This clip, so Cleotrapa actually confronted her on the tour about this, where like, you know, she was having a situation where she was trying to figure out why am I being treated this way, and she was venting about it to like the makeup artist and like, you know, her like Ice Spice's team. So then finally one day Ice Spice is taking a shower and, you know, she goes in the bathroom and does her makeup and decides to talk to her about this, like she airs her grievances.
In the shower?
This shit comes
while,
with
while
it.
Ice Spice was in the shower. I like it.
That's when you press somebody. They're vulnerable, yeah.
Yeah. You go take a shit while they're in the shower. Nigga, I know where to go. So look.
You know, like, y'all see clearly, this will come with it, bro, right? So fuck it. But the whole thing that's blowing me right now is like talking about some dark energy, trying to compare a tour bus to a slave ship. Like, what are you talking about right now? What? That is crazy to me, bro. That's so crazy to me. Like, you really gonna be friends with somebody for 2 years, but the whole time you feel like they soulless and dark? Like, you sound dumb as hell, bitch. If anything, we both need saving. Like, what the fuck are you talking about, bro? Like, we was dead ass at the, we was at the movie theaters. We was siphoning. Bitch, you not gonna tell the people how we was at an Italian restaurant and you ate so much fucking food, you fucking vacuum, that the server was like, where did the food go? Like, stop it right now. You talking about some, she ain't let me to the back of her room on her tour bus. She had this big ass room. Bitch, can I play with my pussy one time in my bed one time? Like, damn, you want to sleep in my bed every day? That's crazy to me. Anyways, yeah, I'm about to act.
No, I kind of feel her.
This would be a good song. This is the type of shit I want to hear about her songs. I don't want to hear "Thank You" this shit fart. I want to hear "I Can't Play With My Pussy." That she's got some gold here. She needs to write. She needs to write this shit down.
Yeah, that's a bar. Yeah. I can definitely. I think we're gonna chop that up and use it as a drop at some point.
No, because it's like I would love that as a drop because, like you said, it's like how many variations of "Thank You" to "Shit You Not Even a Fart." I feel like that's like every song now. Where it's like, yeah, that's the deep struggle I want to hear about. Talk about how you just yearning to play with your pussy.
Yeah, yo.
But niggas is just in your ear because I feel that like. You ever want to rub one off, but your girl keep judging you? And you trying to explain, it's like, you can't rub it like I do.
These questions just like get so much, they get increasingly more obscure and personal to where I'm like, I want to say I agree with you, but I don't even know what point of reference this experience is coming from. So I might honestly not relate to that. I live in a pro masturbation household.
Yeah, no, but this beef, I mean, even the way she did talk about her though, you could tell that's somebody that's like, that ain't really your friend.
No, they're clearly like,
you fucked up trusting a light skinned chick from the Bronx.
Yeah.
That was the first mistake.
Yeah, people just got to be more selective in their friendships. And, you know, what are they, 23, 22 or some shit? They're young. Yeah. They make mistakes, but it's when you notice everybody around you is making the same mistakes, I think it starts to be a bit of a pattern that you should notice. Maybe try to change it a little bit. Azealia Banks and Cleo Trapper are going to go, are they going on tour or are they just
No. They're just doing a show together.
I actually would love to go to that. If I'm being 100% honest, on Halloween,
yeah,
this is honestly sounds like a good time. You might hear any slur. You might hear like Ice Spice's manager is a bird ass nigga for trying to add insult to injury when a young girl is expressed. Damn, no. All right, so Azealia Banks is on a right mode. Usually she's wrong, but she's like, she must have took like some sort of like fucking medication or something.
No, when Azealia Banks is right, she's right.
Yo, really, like when she's wrong, she's fucking so wrong. when she's right, there is no like she's spot on a lot of the time.
No, but I mean, you know, I do get both sides of it. I get it from the aspect of like, if I saw Beyonce treating Kelly like that, I'm like, yo, that's fucked up. Yeah. Like y'all came up together. We practiced dance moves together. Where you know they not really cool. Then also being an opener complaining about why I gotta carry my own bags. Because you're nobody. And this shit isn't about you. You gotta carry your own bags.
Yeah, like she lucky she ain't get sent to the store. She's never, like musicians and comics gotta hang out more. Because comedians that open, they know their place in the world, which is as a fucking gopher.
Right, yeah. Comedians that open, that's why I'm fortunate enough to have like open for the people that I have open for.
Yeah.
That they treated me in such a way where, you know, I still get treated like a human.
Well, did you ever like open for, did you ever like, you never really went like around like early on with anybody?
No.
So yeah, a lot of us will do that with like people we don't really know that much, but it's like, hey, I drive, you need a driver.
Yeah.
And it just works.
Yeah, because that's how it is. A lot of comedians get road work in New York just from having a driver's license.
But there's no illusion that we're friends. Like it's a business contract.
Yeah, or you'll see like comedians opening for people, like they perform and then after the show they out front selling the headliner's merch.
Yeah, I would never do no shit like that. Because at the end of the day, you got to think of like what you might be getting out of that versus how you, like, you might think it might be better for you in the long run, but think about the ways in which it could also be worse. Like, oh, this guy's going to like me and he's got famous friends, so maybe one day he'll recommend me to somebody. Or he'll be like, remember that kid that used to go fucking do my dry cleaning? Yeah, fuck him. Don't give him anything.
Yeah.
Because he's a fucking loser and he'll say yes to anything. Stand up for yourselves, people. Stop letting light-skinned people run you around fucking the country.
That's going to be us.
Yeah.
I'm going
to be knocking on the door of the tour bus you trying to play with your pussy. I'm like, damn, nigga, I can't play my pussy here. Anthony got a fleshlight that he pet like a cat.